get punished. That's just, that is who you are. Why keep fighting? You have money in the bank, you have a lovely wife, you have your senses. Is there a part, why keep doing fights where, you know, win, lose, or draw, you're going to take a beating. That's the way you are and the way that you fight.
I love boxing. It's hard to stay away from boxing for me, especially when I feel like I'm at my best now. I've had some big battles throughout the years. I've been in this game for 15 years, so you can expect that. I fought some of the best, heaviest, hardest punchers there is in the boxing game. I'm not one to shy away from any battle, you know, and same goes for this fight today. I got this opportunity, and you know, I'm prepared for it. I feel like I'm at my best with my new trainer, Robert Garcia. He's not only sharpened up my skills, my defense, and you know, I'm not gonna say that he's turned me into a new fighter, but he's definitely turned me into a lot better fighter.
And Keith, this to you. You and I have talked in the past. Forget about the mental, you know, recovery in terms of wondering, will I break this? Will I injure this? You're happily married. You have money in the bank. I'm guessing these 2 years have been hell for you, just going through physical therapy, surgeries. Why do you do this? Why not just retire? You can do TV, maybe movies. Why do a sport where your body's been put through probably the ringer and more surgeries than a crash unit?
Look, I fought Danny Garcia with bone spurs. I fought, who did I fight? Diego Chavez with stitches in my hand. Nobody knows about that. You know, I've fought, man. I'm a fighter, you know. You're talking to a world-class fighter. And like Jose Cito Lopez said, at the end of the day, man, a real fighter ends up getting addicted to the game. You get addicted to many things in life. But there's nothing in this life that's better than being in that arena under those lights and being a part of the action, baby. There's nothing better than that, you know? And the legacy's not over, you know? Yeah, I could have possibly been a Hall of Famer from unifying the belts with Danny Garcia, but that's not enough for me, you know? Really, I've told you guys many times since the beginning of time, I got an O, I'm not afraid to let it go. If you can beat me, you know? So ultimately, I'm just waiting for God to present to me a man that's better than me. You know, I'm here on the journey to meet that better man on this planet. And you know, sadly enough, there might not be one.
Marco Nuala, Sporting News. Keith, I know you're fully concentrated on this fight, but in 2019, do you feel like due to your absence, you need a fight with Crawford or Spence to prove that you're still in this division?
No. Look, what I need to do is come back in the ring, stay healthy, be active, have some great fights or some good fights this year. And I think, you know, we'll possibly still save some of the great ones. We're still in our prime. There's still a little bit of time on the calendar. I like the year 2020, man. It just sounds really nice. It's an Olympic year. I like the year 2020 because 19 is the get back year. 19, Keith Thurman has to remind you who Keith Thurman is, why Keith Thurman is one of the baddest men at 147, why you need to always mention me when you mention the others, and, you know, hopefully put my name first. At the end of the day, I'm here to make a statement that one time is back. I'm going to do hopefully two fights this year. And because of the long layoff, if I'm blessed, if it does not go into deep waters, if we're able to shut this show down early, in January, there's a lot of room for the rest of the year. I would love, deep down, two is enough, but I would love to sneak in three fights and just be back active so that I know that I can bring my best into the sport. I got one belt, I'm missing one belt. So that's on my mind this year in 2019, is to reestablish my own accomplishments and then move forward from there. There's a curveball with the Pacquiao fight, you know, who if Pacquiao wins, How much longer does he want to fight? How much of a challenge does he want to step up to in the ring? Does he get a draw with AB? Do they fight 2, 3, 4, 5 times for the rest of both of their careers? Who knows? But that's a fight out there. What if Sean Porter loses to Ugas? Then Thurman wants his belt back. He's got to go see that Cuban, you know? So we take it one fight at a time. January 26th, Jose Cito Lopez, you know, Riverside Rocky, he says, I'm not going to be champion by the 27th, you know? So we got our eyes set on that, you know?